Item number, SCP-100. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-100 is to have 6 guards patrolling the interior of the perimeter's fencing, and 2 guards dedicated to the monitoring of the interior and exterior of both warehouses and the residential building, with rotations to occur every 3 hours. Any unauthorized personnel found within SCP-100 are to be detained for questioning, prior to amnestic administration and release. 3 guards are to remain within the storefront of SCP-100, with rotations to occur every 8 hours. The storefront front entrance is to remain locked at all times, with keys provided to necessary personnel. Private property and no trespassing signs are to be posted on the front of the storefront to deter any drivers from stopping at SCP-100. Any constructs SCP-101 creates are to be removed from SCP-100 and melted down into slag, with the exception of SCP-100-2-A and SCP-100-2-B. Should SCP-101 become uncooperative, SCP-100-2-A and SCP-100-2-B may be removed from SCP-100 until the time that SCP-101 becomes cooperative again. The largest of the 2 warehouses within SCP-100 has been converted into a basic research facility. All objects created by SCP-101, excluding SCP-102-A and SCP-102-B, may be used for research purposes. Testing on SCP-101 itself may only be conducted with written permission from the acting head researcher. Description: SCP-100 is an abandoned scrapyard, 80 kilometers from South Carolina, known as Jamaican Joe's Junkyard Jubilee. The scrapyard covers roughly 5,000 square meters of fenced-off land, consisting of 2 warehouses, a storefront, and a small residential building, as well as neglected land and land used for storage. SCP-100 holds roughly 1,500 vehicles, both pressed and unpressed, as well as roughly 1,400 kilograms of separate scrap, estimated to be worth $5,000, or 3,870 euros. SCP-100's anomalous effect manifests through SCP-101 and its constructs, including SCP-102-A and SCP-102-B. Autonomy is lost when SCP-101 or one of its objects cross the fenced perimeter of SCP-100, remaining in this state until reintroduction. SCP-101 is an autonomous, sapient, humanoid construct consisting mostly of copper piping, uninsulated copper wiring, and aluminum cans. SCP-101 lacks the ability for written or verbal communication. However, it possesses the ability to communicate using rudimentary sign language. SCP-101 is largely uninterested in conversation outside of sales, and information gathered from it has been limited. SCP-101 appears to possess skill in craftsmanship, demonstrating the ability to operate tools such as arc welders, drills, and power saws, as well as heavy machinery such as car compressors and forklifts. SCP-101 possesses the ability to create autonomous constructs similar to itself, using material available within SCP-100. SCP-101 tends to create 4 specific animals: iguanas, crocodiles, turtles, and flamingos. However, SCP-101 has been known to craft other species, such as domestic pets. To maintain compliance, SCP-101 has been allowed to keep 2 objects, labeled SCP-100-2-A and SCP-100-2-B. SCP-102-A and SCP-102-B are constructs superficially resembling insects, assumed to be created by SCP-100, as they have occupied SCP-100 since the initial discovery of SCP-100. The names Raymone and Beatrice are welded into the backs of SCP-102-A and SCP-102-B, respectively. They appear to operate as both companions as well as guards for SCP-100, as they patrol the perimeter of SCP-100 except during intervals of interaction with SCP-101. SCP-101 appears to follow a ritualistic schedule, repeating the same actions daily. From 0800 to 1500 hours, SCP-101 enters the storefront of SCP-100, seating itself behind a counter and attempting to bargain with any humans within the storefront. Occasionally, SCP-101 will return to the yard prematurely for reasons unknown. From 1500 to 1600 hours, SCP-101 interacts with SCP-102-A and SCP-102-B, communicating using vague hand and arm gestures. Interaction tends to consist of grooming, repair, and activities resembling fetch and hide-and-seek. From 1600 to 2000 hours, SCP-101 performs various tasks, including taking stock of material within SCP-100, cleaning and maintaining tools and heavy machinery, and cleaning the interiors and exteriors of buildings present within SCP-100. From 2000 hours to 0000 hours, SCP-101 performs what is assumed to be leisurely acts, ranging from creating new constructs, interacting with SCP-102-A and SCP-102-B, and patrolling SCP-100. From 0000 hours to 0800, SCP-101 enters the residential building, where it remains seated at a desk for the duration of this time. In the event that a human enters the storefront of SCP-100 during the interval of time SCP-101 is seated behind the counter, SCP-101 will attempt to bargain with them, using a variety of gestures to convey meaning. Most attempts by SCP-101 are to sell scrap, figures of its own creation, or repair services. However, it has been known to purchase scrap. Despite SCP-101's inability to read, it possesses the ability to perform basic mathematics, as demonstrated by sales. Sales made by SCP-101 are typically met with some degree of unfairness. SCP-101 has been known to intentionally use faulty scales and contaminate scrap piles with cheaper metals, and has demonstrated knowledge of the area of effect within SCP-100, as SCP-101 has sold constructs repeatedly, despite the loss of autonomy when exiting SCP-100. Efforts to confront SCP-101 about this have been met with both distress and indifference, with referral to a sign posted on the wall reading, "No refunds, man," happening regardless of SCP-101's emotional response. SCP-101 was discovered on 11/09/76, following reports of strange machines operating from within the scrapyard. These rumors were discredited as urban legends, and a Foundation agent was sent to SCP-100 to act as the landowner until containment was performed under the guise of property sale. A wooden privacy fence was built along the former perimeter of SCP-100. One-way windows were installed in the storefront, and a highway now running through the nearby town of redirects the majority of civilian traffic. Addendum 100A. Records show the property is owned by one Joseph Duvall, with the mailing address sharing the same name. Local utility companies report billing had stopped approximately 3 months before the discovery of SCP-100, which was found abandoned save for SCP-101, SCP-102-A, SCP-102-B, and several avian and canine figures, presumed to be made by SCP-101. The initial sweep of the buildings revealed the residential building to be mostly bare, with the only sign of former occupants being a note found taped to the door of the storefront. Incident 100A. On 060305, SCP-101 created a humanoid, autonomous construct, 10 centimeters in height, the first time SCP-101 has done so. Significant effort was put into this construct compared to others, with greater detail applied to the construct, including facial features, and JJ welded into the back of the construct, and stainless steel making up the majority of the construct. SCP-101 placed the construct on the counter of the storefront for the duration of the scheduled interval, both using vague gestures to seemingly communicate with one another. Following the confiscation of this construct, SCP-101 remained seated within the residential building of SCP-100 for a total of 10 days. Document 100A. The following is a copy of the note recovered upon discovery of SCP-100. Out to lunch. Please see assistant. JJ. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-099, The Portrait, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.